بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا لله تعالى، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. اللهم صل وسلم عليه في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى يا رب العالمين. السلام الله عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. First, it's always a pleasure to be here in the windy city. Now it seems to be the rainy city. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for people of this city, inshaAllah, and make the matar lana wa la alayna. We praise Allah for this gathering. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent as an embodiment of the Qur'an. عائشة بنت أبي بكر رضي الله تعالى عنها, she said, كان خلق النبي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم القرآن. She said that the behavior of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is the Quran, was the Quran. In another good narration, she said, القرآن يمشي. It was like a walking Quran صلى الله عليه وسلم. And today, الحمد لله, we gather لله سبحانه وتعالى for the sake of Allah to discuss the qualities of men in the Qur'an. Talking about different important attributes that the men and also the women, because Ibn Rushd, rahimahullah, in Bidayat al-Mujtahid, he said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions men, unless He explicitly makes it known, also women are included in the verses or ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, our focus is on the men. And wallahi, I'm sure many of us will agree that the man is an endangered species. If you were to turn on the Discovery Channel next to the North African dodo bird on the endangered species list, you will find al-rijal. You will find men. This is not an insult to our brothers, because this is not our brother's fault. But this is the fault of many factors, one of them being the extreme infective vice of feminism, which is slowly oozed into the minds of people and the hearts of people. But most importantly is the marji'iyya of the Muslim, the reference point of the Muslim. Why? Not only men, but women. Because sisters, the Arabs, when they wanted to pray a woman, they will say about her, she's a man. She's a man. But more importantly, especially for those of us here in the West, the marji'iyya of the Muslim, the reference of the Muslim, the reference point in the life of the Muslim is what shapes his or her conceptualization of reality. What the ulama al-manatiqa refer to as at-tasawwur, how somebody conceptualizes the things around them. And when we look at the Muslim community and we see the high rate of divorce, we should not be shocked when we discover that the men who married these Muslim sisters, their marji'iyya, their reference point was a person whose claim to fame is being shot 9 times, living and dressing as though he's in the penitentiary. Who talks about women in his songs, which could only lead someone to chronic misogynism. On the other hand, if we ask our sisters, for example, what is their marji'iyya? What is their reference point? Maybe they will say the movies. Maybe they will say tawaf in the mall. Maybe they will say Bollywood. Maybe they will say musharafi. But the reference in your life is what shapes how you think and how you look. And it creates attributes and behaviors in your life, whether you like it or not. Whether you like it or not, it creates a personality and it creates an understanding. For that reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made the Qur'an the book of huda, the book of guidance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This is the book, there's no doubt in this book. This is a book, يَهْتَدِي بِهَا, that the believer يَهْتَدِي بِهِ, that the believer, he seeks to be guided by this book. He or she actualizes the teaching of the book. In short, the Qur'an is a book to be studied and a book to be acted on. And that's why the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they would not read more than 10 verses of Quran. The minimum was 3, as related by Abdullah bin Mas'ud in Ibn Kathir's tafsir. And they would not go beyond more than 10 verses of Quran until they acted on those verses of Quran, understood those verses of Quran, and lived and made those verses of Quran part of their reality, part of their existence. Like when we were young, and we used to play basketball. I remember back in the days I used to school YM in basketball. We'll see what happens in this visit, inshallah, because I brought my shoes. So you better watch out. But I remember when I was young and I used to play basketball, and then in the beginning I would shoot with two hands. How many of you, when you first started playing basketball, you shot with two hands? And your coach told you, don't shoot with two hands, shoot with one hand. And you found it difficult. But over time, you develop what's called a muscle memory pattern. You acquire the ability to shoot with one hand. The same thing, we should approach the Quran, that the characteristics and the attributes of those people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise them in the Quran should be practiced, should be studied, should be learned, should be acted on. In fact, after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, we find the verse of Surah An-Nur, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you go to visit someone and they don't respond to you, leave. At the end of his life, he went to someone's house who wasn't home. He knew that they weren't home and he left. Somebody asked him, why? He said, this is the only order in the Quran, مثلاً, I had left to act on. Look at the understanding of Quran. It's different than many of our understandings. So if we take, for example, popular culture, what's the portrayal of men in popular culture now? And compare it, for example, to the 50s or the 60s. In the 50s and the 60s, what sociologists tell us, men were portrayed as the benevolent patriarch, John Wayne, man. John Wayne had a six-shooter and still killed 100,000 people with only 6 shots. I can never figure it out. Be home by dinner, play with the kids, and read a book to his wife and go to sleep. Then you had Ward Cleaver, Sheikh Ward. Ward Cleaver goes to work, takes care of his family, feeds Beaver and his brother Wally. Everything's chill. He's a man. He's in charge. He's Qawwa. He's in charge of his family. But look now at the man in popular culture. Because if your reference sister, if your reference brother is primarily toxic pop sludge that's being pumped into your hearts and brains, realize that it creates what's called a tasawwur in your mind, how you look at reality, whether you like it or not. So from John Wayne and Ward Cleaver, we've arrived at the apex of masculinity, the height of intellectualism, the peak of beautiful articulation, Homer Simpson. Look what they did to the man. And Ed Bundy. Look what Al Bundy. I don't know, I'm old now. Look what they did to the man. So that's why now women, they'll be like, oh, I would send them to the halal market to buy the achar. But he probably doesn't even know where the achar is. Before, you'd send them to go kill the goat and pick up the achar on the way home. But now the way that you look at men has been affected by feminism and popular culture. And you give them the wings to be the Khalifa of Allah. The woman is what men, especially when they're married, take meaning from. It makes the fabric of their life. Seriously. That's why the Prophet said the best thing of this dunya is what? Imra'u Salihah, the righteous woman. So dear brothers and sisters, pull back from those things and replace those things with Quran, with Sunnah. Today inshallah, we'll spend a few moments talking about some of the more important characteristics of men mentioned in the Quran. We will not have time to do all of them. Actually, this is like a 6-CD lecture that I gave, so you're going to get the cliff notes. But in general, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, Surah An-Nur, Allah says, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ اللَّهُ نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this verse, is going to give us the asas, the foundations of the Muslim personality, whether male or whether female. And Allah says, Allah is the light of everything in the heavens and the earth. Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, as related by Imam Ibn Kathir, that Ibn Abbas, he said, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard, means Allah is the guide. يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ سِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Allah is the one who guides everything in the heavens and the earth. مَثُلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَةٍ. The example of Allah's light is like this beautiful niche, this lamp. Ubay bin Ka'b, and I hope we can be patient with me as I try to explain this. He said, there's something mahzoof, there's something hidden here in the sentence. Something is missing. مَثَلُ نُورِ الْمُؤْمِنِ فِي صَدْرِ هَذَا الْمُؤْمِنِ. The example of Allah's light, which is in the heart of the believer, is the meaning of the verse, according to the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. It's like what? The light that exists in the believer is like this lamp surrounded by this glass that beams out. So the companions of the Prophet said, رضي الله تعالى عنهم وصلى الله عليه وسلم, that the believer, the example of the nur, the guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in the hearts of the believers, those who believe in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like this lamp that's surrounded by this glass that beams light. Some of them said, مشكات صدر المؤمن. The مشكات is the chest of the believer. ومصباح في لا إله إلا الله في صدري. And the misbah is La ilaha illallah, or his heart. وَالزُّجَاجَ, the iman of the believer. And the glass that surrounds this qalb, because why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala see the Qur'an? The beauty of the Qur'an, bear with me, why would Allah describe the believer's heart like a glass, as the ulama mentioned? Because glass is pure and clean. So the one who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his iman is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his tawheed is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ. Then his heart, inshallah, will be clean. See the power of the Quranic narrative. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I have to just say in English because of time, He describes this light that beams from the chest of the believer, male or female, as what? Like the star. كَوْكَبٌ دُرِيٌ وَفِي قِرَاءَ دَرِيءٌ. A bright, bright star. دَرِي means to push. To push, that beams light. It beams light. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the mechanism that makes the whole thing run. And He describes it subhanahu wa ta'ala as زَيْتُون. الزيتون, the pure olive oil. مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية. Allah says, a blessed oil, the olive oil, neither of the east or the west. Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he says this is the balance of the believer. Some ulama said the oil which lights this lamp is the ikhlas of the believer. Some ulama said the oil is what? His knowledge of Quran and Sunnah. The more he increases his knowledge, the stronger the light becomes, the more oil he gives to the lamp. So it starts to beam. Until he becomes, as Allama Iqbal rahimahullah, he mentioned in one of his beautiful poems, that this person, when he begins to live according to the Quran and Sunnah, when the non-Muslim sees him or her in his workplace, in his neighborhood, in his school, walking down the street, on the bus, the only thing that that non-Muslim can say from his fitrah, when he sees that Muslim woman or that Muslim man fulfilling those attributes that Allah mentioned in the Quran, the only thing he can say is فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَ. The believer became such a blessing for humanity that all of humanity bears witness when they see the noble qualities of the believer. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَ. Which one of the favors of your Lord will you deny? Because that believing man and that believing woman in their workplace, in their home, in their school, became a ni'mah to all of creation. And that's why the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, that even the fish in the seas make dua for the alim, for the scholar. Imam Ibn Rajib, he said, why? He said, because that scholar, the knowledge that he took, that zaytun, لا شرقية ولا ولا غربية. That oil that pushes the heart of the believer, the knowledge of the Quran and Sunnah, will cause that alim even to treat the creation of Allah with respect. Thus, the creation of Allah will make du'a for him. Then Allah says, يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار. Then He said, Subhana, this lamp will light, even what, not just light, illuminate everything, even if no fire touches it. There's two things the ulama said. One of them is that the believer is what, he can self-actualize things. He doesn't need someone to always push him or her. Clean your room, bring some bread, go make dawah. I wasn't invited, I'm not going. They didn't even ask me to help with the MSA this time. Be what? Be assertive. The believer doesn't have to have a lot of reminders. Nowadays, we can hear reminders the whole month of Ramadan. And this rusty heart, maybe one tear or two tears. Irbad ibn Sariya, he says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said a few words to us, we start crying and shedding tears. Why? The qalb is with Allah. The qalb is clean, it's open, it's soft and moist. And that's why the ulama, they said, look at wood. Wood is like the heart. The soft wood is the wood that you use for things. But the dry wood, it only has one good purpose. Who knows what that purpose is? To light something on fire. So the heart, which is dry, it only has one purpose. We ask Allah bil-afiyah, will be for the fire. And then Allah says, Subhana, nurun ala nur. Light upon light. Imam Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, rahmatullahi alayhi, mentioned in Madaj al-Salikin, something beautiful here. He said, why did Allah say, nurun ala nur? He said, because that believer, the more they learn from the Quran and the Sunnah and their religion, and the more they understand, they will increase the nur which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in them from the beginning of their birth, or put in them when they accepted Islam. مَا مِن مَوْلُودٍ يُولَدْ إِلَّا عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ. As the Prophet said, no person was born except on fitrah. Another narration, on Islam. And that's a light. So somebody who actualizes this fitrah and then studies and actualizes the Quran and Sunnah in their life, this is nur plus nur. So Allah says, nurun ala nur. After this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the ulama, he mentioned this believer. And see, many of you maybe are saying, wow, the Quran is on another level. I never knew it was like this. Give us some time. Give us some time. Sometimes I feel sad when people ask me, hey, can I listen to the sheikh? Then I ask them, how much time a day do you spend listening to the sheikh? Oh, just when I go to work and I come home from work. Or just when I go to school and come home from school. Then I ask them, how much Quran do you listen to? Well, I didn't listen to the Quran. If you listen to the sheikh more than Quran, fear Allah. Because the Quran is the book that will guide you. Doesn't mean I'm saying it's haram or anything, don't go and start writing something on the internet. But what I'm telling you is priorities with Quran, spend time with Quran. And also the imams in communities have to give tafsir of Quran, I believe, at least once a week to the people. That will bring them close to the Quran, back to the Quran. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this believer, then He mentions the places that are beloved to the believer. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions, fi buyutin, in the houses. Here He means masajid. After He mentioned this believer, He mentioned the masajid of Allah, the masjids of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fi buyutin adhina Allah an turfa'a wa yuzkara fih wa yuzkara ismahu fih. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in those homes where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the masajid where He has given permission that His name be mentioned. Some ulama said, adhina Allah. Allah has given permission in the masajid that His name should be mentioned. This is a proof that we should not talk about bad things in the masjid, because Allah did not give permission for this. And Allah mentions that His name is mentioned there, and the dhikr of Allah is made there. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهِ بِالْغَدُوِّ فِيهَا بِالْغَدُوِّ وَالْأَصَالِ. That in those masajid, Allah's name is magnified. Here's the first quality of men mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the passive form. It's called mabni lil majhul. He hid the subject. He said, somebody mentions Allah. Somebody remembers Allah. Then the next page, the first verse, rijalun min. لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. Men who business and trade do not take them from the remembrance of Allah. How many of us after MSA, we became lost in the mad sea of corporate America or the mad sea trying to find jobs and be stable. It's important, we have to. But how many of us have lost that balance? The reason is, after MSA, what is there for that generation to do? What organizations are going to bring them in and utilize them? MSA is some of the most beautiful days of my life were at MSA. Why? Because I didn't have any cha-cha breathing down my neck, telling me, don't put your poster there. You have to fill out a paper to do this. We have freedom. Free at last. Free at last. Thank God Almighty. Free at last. In the MSA. But as soon as we got out of the MSA, we had all those ideas, all those thoughts. We went to the masajid, we got slapped in the mouth. As some people said, they want to talk about hijrah from America, we see Muslims making hijrah from the masajid. And most of the Muslims who are making hijrah from the masajid are between the ages of 25 and 35. The struggle to keep that balance, the struggle to maintain that active level that we acquire through MSA after we get done. So Allah says, رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. Men who business and trade do not keep them from the remembrance of Allah. The first quality of men mentioned in the Quran is what? That they understand the comprehensive nature of ibadah. That they understand shumuliyatul ibadah, the comprehensive understanding of ibadah. One brother told me, Ya Suhaib, how can I remember Allah at Cisco? You know what is Cisco? I said, look man, I didn't say it like that. I said, look my dear brother, if Yunus alayhi salatu salam could remember Allah in the belly of a fish, you can remember Allah in Cisco. He said, subhanAllah. So the first quality is a comprehensive understanding of life, that this life is for ibadah. وَمَا خَلَقُتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want you to appreciate something from the Quran. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْأَصَالِ وَالْأَغُضِ وَالْأَصَالِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, somebody praises Allah in those masajids, in the morning and in the evening. The next verse says, رِجَالٌ. In Arabic, it's though somebody said, مَنْ هَؤُلَى. Who are those who magnify Allah and recognize Allah in the morning and the evening? And the answer came, رِجَالٌ. Because if I told you, man, somebody left the door open, you tell me, who? So here it's though, somebody remembers Allah in the morning and in the evening, in the buyut of Allah. The one who's reading Quran will say, who are they? رِجَالٌ. Men. لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. Who business transactions and selling doesn't take them from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't pull them away from being attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other quality of men mentioned in the Quran can be found in Surah Tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He talks about Masjid al-Dirar. This was a masjid that was built by the hypocrites in Medina to try to throw a clog in the Prophet ﷺ and his companions' da'wah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposed them in the Quran, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned masajid. The masajid or the masjid, usila'at ala taqwa, min awwal yawmin ahaqqa an taquma fihi rijal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look, both times He mentions masajid. Allah says, that masjid whose foundation was on taqwa has the right that it should be, the salah should be observed in that masjid. What type of people are in the masjid? فِيهِ رِجَالٌ مِنْ We know the Prophet said, do not forbid your women from going to the masjid. But here he says, فِيهِ رِجَالٌ What type of qualities, and now فِعْلُ مُضَارِعُ is going to be used as a sifa. If you understand the Arabic language, فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ Or it could be حَال, يُحِبُّونَ أَن يَتَطَهَّرُوا وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُطَّهِّرِينَ In this masjid are men يُحِبُّونَ أَن يَتَطَهَّرُوا Who love, if you look at the translation perhaps it says love to be pure. But this is not the correct translation. فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ أَن يَتَطَهَّرُوا This is عَلَى وَزْنِ تَفَاعُلِ Ibn Malik said وَبَعْضُ فَالْفِعْلُ مَنْ يُحْكِمْ تَصَرُّفَهُ يَحُزْ مِنَ لُغَةِ الْأَبْوَابَ وَسُبَلَ You can translate that later on. Because I can't translate it. Said, فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ أَن يَتَطَهَّرُوا Allah says, in these masajid are men who what? تَفَاعُلْ They love to be pure. They seek to be pure. They want to be pure. Not, they're pure. This ta is called ta talabiyya. They want to be clean. They want to be pure. And also, it means over time, step by step. So not only do they want to be pure, but they have what? Tadarruj in this tarbiyya, that they take things step by step. The quality of the Prophet ﷺ was a step by step system. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal, He described the companions as what? As a stem, the shot from a seed, a weak stem. كَزَرْعٍ أَخْرَجَ شَطَأَهُ فَآزَرَهُ فَاسْتَغْلَدَ فَاسْتَوَى عَلَى سُوكٍ Why Allah used this description of the Sahaba like a stem, a weak stem that came out of the seed. Over time it grew until it became strong and stood on its own. What did the ulama say? Get ready to get hit with the beauty of the Quran. They said, the seed is Muhammad alayhi salatu salam and the stem that shot from this seed are his companions. So over time, he, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he's given tarbiyah, he's nurturing this stem till it can stand on its own. الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا Don't you feel lucky to be the people who have the Qur'an? Don't you feel an honor? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala istafakum that you can read the Qur'an, you can hold the Qur'an, you can recite the Qur'an, you can memorize the Qur'an, you can pick up the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every word and every letter you read are like drops of hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the job of the Qur'an and the sunnah is to purify your heart and make it soft. That's why Allah anzala al-Qur'an, Allah send down the Quran and the word anzala like rain because the job of rain is to bring life to a dead land the job of the Quran and sunnah is to bring life to the dead hearts yuhibbuna an yatatahharu they love to be pure they want to be pure and this verb is a transitive verb in the Arabic language called al-mutaaddi wal-mutaaddi da aw hada this mutaaddi requires an object But the object is hidden. Allah didn't mention the object. فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ أَن يَتَطَهَّرُوا قُلُوبَهُمْ أَوْ حَيَاتَهُمْ أَوْ شَخْصِيَّتَهُمْ Allah, He hid the object. Why? This is one of the beauties of Quran in Arabic. When you read the Quran in Arabic, if you come across a verb and the object is missing, that means it's your job as the speaker to put the object in the sentence. That way Allah grabs you and rips you now. Virtual reality. Now you're in virtual Quran. You're in the Quran. So for example in Surah Al-Hujurat, لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ Don't put anything in front of Allah and His Messenger. Allah didn't mention what? Because you and me, all of us have our own sins and our own mistakes. So for example, if I look at bad things on the internet, لَا تُقَدِّمُوا Don't put in front of Allah and His Messenger. Then I put the object. Looking at bad things. If I backbite people, do not put in front of Allah and His Messenger, backbiting. If I'm harsh on my wife, don't put in front of Allah and His Messenger being harsh on your wife. That way the Quran pulls you into it as you read the Quran. And here in Surah Tawbah, the same thing. فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يحبون أن يتطهروا in these masajid are men who love to be pure. Pure what? It's not mentioned. That way you men will put your own problem in the verse. And that leads us, not only do the men love to be pure, the reason that Allah doesn't mention the maf'ul, as mentioned by the scholars of usul and al-lugha, is to feed what? Shumuliyya again. Comprehensiveness. Purify anything. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُطَّهِّرِينَ فِي الْحَقِيقَ مُتَطَهِّرِينَ Allah loves those who purify, the pure men, who are constantly pure. We have to stop now for the adhan. Insha'Allah, after Salat al-Maghrib, we'll continue. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يجعلنا من رجال الذين يتعلمون كتابه ويتمثلون به في حياتهم وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله
As for Allah, nothing but Allah Ba is the beginning of Bismillah Ta is for taqwa, bewaring of Allah And tha is for thawab, a reward Ja is for Jannah, the garden of paradise Ha is for Hajj, the blessed pilgrimage Kha is for Khatam, the seal of the prophethood Given to the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Da is for Deen